I loved all the experiences, but I think the first was just the most magical because, well, it was the first time. And we had no idea it was going to be as successful as it was, but we were all shooting in Santa Rosa, California, which is north of San Francisco. Really beautiful area. And it was an odd experience because you're obviously shooting nights the entire time, so it was a bit like being vampires. But we had great fun, you know. We were all very new to the business. I'd been on Party of Five. Courtney had been on Friends for a year. I'd been on the show for a year. And Drew was really the biggest name. Everybody else, you know, none of us really had names yet. So it was exciting for all of us. Very new. You know, the final sequence of the first Scream took about 3 weeks. But it was great fun. I think Matt Lillard and Jamie Kennedy and Skeet were all fantastic in their energy in it. So we had a lot of fun shooting it. Most mortifying one was actually, I think, having to do that singing, the one where my boyfriend sings to me in the second the second movie. For some reason, I found that very embarrassing. Most fun, I don't know if I have one moment that was most fun. I think the cast, we all had a blast together all the time. Wes Craven was always in his seat giggling. Because he's twisted and wonderful.
So but you're not a fan of being serenaded then? Is there anyone here fancy serenading?
No, please, thank you.
Yeah, what was it like to work with Wes Craven?
Gosh, he's phenomenal. I mean, he really obviously knows his stuff and has such a passion for this genre and has a great sense of humor, and I think that's why he's able to make such good movies within this genre. I think you have to have a sense of humor within it. He gets such glee out of being disgusting. but he's great. He's just an amazing person and a very, very good director for actors as well. He really helped me a lot to get into moments when I was, when I was tired or trying to get my energy out, because obviously with that character is a lot of heightened energy. And he was great.
Did you always like to know the killer up front, or was it a surprise at the end? Or
I always knew. They felt that it was important that I know. But on, I think, on 3 and 4, they didn't tell the rest of the cast. Which was an interesting choice, but it worked. You know, I think they also just didn't want it to get leaked.
What's your favorite scary movie?
The Changeling with George C. Scott. I think it was made in the 70s, and it's absolutely terrifying. It's not a film that everybody knows about, but it's really great.
That's a while back, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Did you see that at a very young age? Was it?
I saw it at, it was the first horror film I ever saw. I think I was 11 years old, and I was at a friend's house for a sleepover, and I had nightmares for a month after that. So. My favorite death in Scream? I think people like the Rose McGowan one. Where her head goes, she goes up in the, I don't know if you know, where she gets killed in the garage door. It's pretty twisted. People wonder whether I don't regret in any sense doing the Scream movies. They've done phenomenal things for my career. And yet, at points in my career, I think it hindered me in certain ways when maybe someone wouldn't cast me because I was so well known at that moment for Scream. Yeah. And the energy was so toward that. But at the same time, I can't regret it. It's been incredible for me, and they're great movies, and there's a great audience, and people love them. And I've gotten past that now, too, I think. So I don't think there should be fear about doing it. And, in acting, it used to be if you were in films, you didn't do TV. If you were in TV, you wanted to do film. But there's such a crossover now of the mediums, and I think crossover of genres as well now, so.
Scary
movies.
Yeah, and the portrayal of your characters in that.
Were you offended, or did you go and see it and just laugh?
To be honest, I've only seen 40 minutes of the first one, but I thought it was very funny, and I know people really loved them, and I'm happy for the company that made so much money on them. It was great. And in what is it they say, mockery or what, imitation is the greatest form of flattery?
Absolutely.
So there you go. I got to go with that.
I think that's the right attitude, isn't it? Yeah.
Which one would you prefer, the Scream movie with Tori Spelling or the scary movie that you only seen 40 minutes?
Well, I've only seen 40 minutes, so it's hard to say. I thought, you know what, Tori had such a great sense of humor doing that, I think. I thought it was very brave of her to do that, because in some sense it was making fun of her career in a way. And she's actually a really nice girl and actually quite bright, so I have to go for that one. I have not seen the Scream TV show. I've been asking people as they come up to me here, you know, who've seen it, what they think, and it seems to be some mixed reviews. But, you know, sometimes it takes a show a while to get a rhythm going, and maybe it'll end up being wonderful. I will see it, because, you know, Wes is involved, and I'm sure a few people are going to ask me about it. So I have a 3-year-old. I don't have a lot of time to watch TV, so.
Will there be a Scream 5?
You know, I have no idea what the answer is to that question. I think initially the intention with the fourth Scream was that it be a new trilogy. But I think they had hoped that the film would do better than it did. And they've gone and made the television series, which has just come out now. So I'm not sure that it would make sense to go back to a film. But you never know with the Weinsteins. I mean, they could decide tomorrow that they want to do it. And I, you know, I don't know where we would go with it. We'd have to come up with something really good. Because otherwise it might be a bit repetitive.